Hi, everybody. Laura here for Simon Says Stamp. Thank you so much for joining me today. I'm excited to bring you the reveal of the Stamptember 2021 release, and boy, is she a doozy. There is a lot, so much. There's new inks, new blender brushes, stamps, dyes, clings, foil plates. I'm going to walk you through all of these exciting new products, starting with 13 new background cling designs. This first one is called Hand-Lettered Holiday Background. And as always, the background clings are red rubber mounted on a cushy foam, and it's clingy, so it sticks to your stamp positioner beautifully. And I love this gorgeous handwritten look. That looks like Christina Werner's handwriting to me. Next up is outline ornaments. Great one for the holiday. A lot of different things you can do with that. You can color it in, or you could just do just a plain old embossed background. Moving right along, we've got interlocking leaves. Very modern and fresh. Here's a larger one called Scroll Flourish, and this would be sized perfectly for a slimline background. Next, we have Peel Apart Fall Leaves. Now, this is one of those that you can peel apart. It's actually three different segments in this background cling. So you could peel off a part. Maybe you just want to stamp a little corner of a leaf cluster, or maybe you want to stamp it all together. You can tear it apart, peel it apart, and you can piece it back together, pieces back perfectly for one large image. This really gives you a lot of mileage for your design possibilities. Okay, this next one lights my fire. It's called Large Kaleidoscope. Just look at it. Just adore the geometric beauty of it all. And the next one too, Hexagon Background. Look at that clean, fresh design. I love it. Okay, moving right along for the coffee lovers, we have coffee drinks. And this one gives you all the names of those fancy coffees, and this would be great for those coffee-themed projects. Next up, we have Concentric Doodle. Very unique, organic, kind of hypnotic. And then this is a unique one called Printmaking Florals Background. And this one's unique in that each one of those rows is its own peel apart strip of a stamp. So you can peel it apart. Maybe you just want to do a border, or you can piece them all together and do a whole Scandinavian background. I really like this unique, fresh, clean, Scandinavian modern design. Okay, this next one is a classic, the good old ledger paper. Great for teacher cards, school-themed projects, journaling, scrapbooking, or just a classic notebook background that I personally love. Okay, for the Halloween lovers, we have Spooky Eyes. All the different sizes of the spooky, spooky eyes. And then lastly, for Christmas, we've got Old Christmas Tree with kind of a modern, whimsical take on that. Okay, now these are standalone stamp sets. They do not have coordinating dies to go with them. First up, we have Drink Coffee for the coffee lovers. And this one has a lot of different mixture of large and small sentiments with unique combination of fonts. I think it's really cute. And then we have raindrops. So you get different patterns of raindrops, but I think those could also be made into flower petals. And then you get a bunch of different raindrop themed sentiments to pair with it. We have Waves of Change. Now, this is one of those I think you could use like a multi-step. You could stamp that large solid wave here, and then you could do the outline with or without, and you could add extra detail with that third stamp. So you could do a lot of different variations, and then there's lots of sentiments to pair with. We have Printmaking Florals. Again, could be a multi-step stamping. You've got the leaves, the solid for the florals, or you could just use the outline and color them, or you could fill them in. You know, a lot of different ways you could do it. There's sentiments to go with those. Printmaking Houses, I love this one. Anything architecture. So you've got the outline, and you could use these solid images to color it in. Or you could just color in the outline with your, you know, medium of choice. Foxglove is a beautiful, intricate floral stamp set with some classy sentiments to go with. And then lastly, we have Document It. Now, this is a larger stamp set. It kind of looks like something you'd see on the inside of a book or a ledger. There's all the months of the year, a couple sentiments. And this kind of has an old vintage worn-in feel to it. Great for a book lover. Okay, moving on to the Stampin' Die combination sets. This first one is called Big Day. And it's got three adorable little girls. There's coordinating dies to go with it. This would be great for a wedding, maybe a baptism, any big occasion for a little girl. And I did notice there is a little die that's called Itty Bitty Tag, and it is sized perfectly for that little banner image that's in the Big Day stamp set. So if you want to make a little banner to go above the, you know, the heads, maybe personalize it with a name. Okay, moving along to Dance and Twirl for the dancers in your life. You know, I like to dance. Maybe you just want to make a card for your crafty friend who loves to dance. The coordinating dice to go with that as well. Okay, furry friends. This one does have coordinating dice. I don't have it to show you, but there are dice to pair with this. I love the jumbo sentiments. Cute little critters, some balloons, and various sentiments for many different occasions. Next, we have gift wrap. And this has coordinating dies as well. This is perfect for the holidays or maybe birthdays or any gift-giving occasion. Okay, moving right along. If you love gnomes and you love Halloween, you're going to love Halloween gnomies. There's coordinating dies to go with it. And look at these cute little gnomes. One sitting in a pumpkin. There's a spider web. There's some candy corn. Look at the gnome riding the broom. I mean, so adorable. Okay, we've got you covered. Maybe you're not a cutesy lover, but you're a classy type of a crafter. You're going to like Happy Poinsettia. This is one of those multi-step stamp sets where you can layer those images for a beautiful poinsettia. Next is Lined Leaves. Maybe you're a geometric lover. This one's great for the fall, and it's got a great fresh, you know, clean lined look to it. Along those lines is Merry Christmas Trees. This one has a more whimsical feel, but it's great for Christmas. And there's coordinating dies to go with that one as well. Next up is Painted Leaves. And this one's great for fall. It's got the coordinating dies to go with it. This is one of those multi-step stamp sets. I like that it's labeled. So for the solid A leaf image, you have the detail A. It's labeled. For the B, you've got the B. C, you've got the C. D, you got the D. So you see where I'm going with that. Now for the Halloween lovers, we've got Toil and Trouble. It's got the classic Halloween, you know, images with the witch's feet and the witch's hat and the broom. Now here's a classic Extra Large Greetings 3. I don't have the dies, but there are coordinating dies to go with this. This is like one of those that never goes out of style. I love the mixture of fonts. I love the size of these sentiments. And then we have Too Cute to Spook. If you like Halloween, but you're not too spooky, you kind of like it cutesy, this one's for you. And it's really adorable. There are coordinating dies to go with this. Cute little ghosts. And then some great solid sentiments there. Next up, we have Extra Large Birthday Greetings. Again, there's coordinating dies to go with it. Another classic mixture of fonts. The sentiments have a great size to them, and I feel like this set will never go out of style. Okay, moving along to the standalone dies. There's a bunch of these, and I die cut almost every single one to show you what they look like. This first one is called Flip to Low. I die cut this into some blue cardstock to show you how it's like a hello, and with a hello on top, but it's flipped upside down. So you could flip the card around. It's kind of almost like interactive. It's a flip to low. Now this one is really cute. It's called Gnome Treehouse. I put one of these little doodads together because, you know, well, you got to see it to believe it. It's really cute for the gnome projects. Now here's one. Paper layering circles. I think you get about 6 or so of these kind of organic shapes. And look at this. It's like artwork to me. I mean, I just love that. Of course, I popped it up to give it some dimension. And then we have window webs. Now, I die cut this, but it really, I mean, you need to see the dies almost, because what they do is they make windows with the webbing, and they don't cut the outside. They cut into a card. So you're actually making a window into your card that is in the shape of a web, and you get 3 different sizes. You don't have to use all three at once. You can, you know, use a little one if you just want a little web. Moving right along, we have ghosts and tree, and I die cut these to show you. It's kind of a spooky looking tree for Halloween, and then a couple of not so spooky, kind of cute, if you ask me, ghosts. So you could use those together, or you could use the ghosts separately. Next up is ornate leaves, and these are very ornate and delicate, but very detailed in their shape. Great for the fall season, great for Thanksgiving. Next up is the Thankful For You, and this gives you two different sentiment dies, and it gives you the word die and the shadow. So I did the word die out of white, and I did the shadow out of kind of a burnt orange. And it's got Thankful For You, and then just the Thankful. Great for Thanksgiving. Okay, here's a big happy birthday word die. I didn't have the correct packaging, but I wanted to show you what it looks like when you put it together. And I did the outline out of teal and the word die out of white. Just a classic scripty happy birthday. Here's another birthday. This one's called Large Happy Birthday. And it has a great size to it. Would fit perfectly on a standard size card. Here's a die set called The Neighborhood. And I die cut each one of these cutie patootie little houses in rainbow order to show you the different shapes and sizes. So cute. Now you don't have to use them all. You could just do one little house, or you could do a row of houses, however you want to orientate them, or, you know, make a composition on a card. Okay, this one's called Slimline Snowbanks. I did not die cut this one to show you, but what it does is you got two different snowbanks. They're sized for a slimline card. Got a couple of cute trees and houses, even some looks like smoke that might come out of a chimney or some snow blowing in the wind. And then we have peace, love, hope, and joy. I die cut that to show you for size. Great scripty holiday word die. Next up is a die set called Slide and Glide. If you like to create interactive cards or slider cards, these are a bunch of different shaped tracks to make little images slide or twirl or go up and down interactive on a card. Maybe you want one to be a hill or one to be a circle. Got you covered with the Slide and Glide. Okay, so now we're moving on to some beautiful floral dies, the Etched Layered Daisy. Put this one together. The detail on it is stunning. And I used two different shades of yellow cardstock to give it a bit of interest. The next die set is called Fine Foxglove. And this one's very intricate and dainty. I adhered the hot pink blooms onto that dainty stem. Be cute to do a row of those foxglove. And this one's called Etched Primrose Blooms. You get two different sizes. So you could do a cluster of these or just use one individual bloom by itself. And then we have the Etched Meadow Flower and Leaves. So you get two different leaves and then one with the bloom. Now for the bloom, I did it twice. I die cut it once out of green and then another time out of white. And I just kind of trimmed off the bloom part and adhered it to the top. So you could do these blooms with a lot of different colors. Next is Etched Layered Daisy Stem, and I put this one together to show you another adorable daisy, but you get the stem and all of that put together. Really, really cute. Something so cheerful about daisies. Okay, and then we have Etched Crocus Stems. Now this one's really beautiful. I like how you get the two different type of blooms that you can layer together or not. So for the pink one, you can see that I put a darker one behind and that gave it a bit of dimension, like it's an open bloom. And then, but if you don't want to, you could do like I did the red one and just keep it more of a one layer flower. Next up, we have the Detail Cloud Plate. This is a full size cover plate and it gives you the tiniest little dotted cloud background pattern on your background panel. And then next we have the Fine Petal Background Plate. Again, full size. And look at this intricate petal lined detail background. Next, we have some unique slimline size detail cover plates. This first one is called Detail Bohemian Slim Plate, and you can see that gorgeous, intricate, dotted bohemian design, and it's sized for a slimline card. This one also is sized for a slimline. It's called the Etched Tall Leaf Spray. It's a very tall etched leaf design, very intricate and really unique to see a leaf that's sized that large for a slimline card. Next we have the Detail Petal Slim Plate, and I die cut this one out of blue cardstock to show you that intricate dotted pedal design, very unique sized for a slimline card. And then next we have this little die called Here for the Booze. And I don't have the correct packaging, but I die cut one to show you what it looks like. Really cute, would pair beautifully with those adorable cutesy Halloween stamp sets. And then we also have a coordinating die set that's called Build a Rainbow. And what this does is pair with the Build a Rainbow stencil. So this is kind of unique to have a coordinating die to pair with a stencil. See how that die coordinates with the cloud border? And then you have the rainbow die that you can build the rainbow with the stencil. You've got the sun ray and the full-size sun, a couple of different sizes of clouds. Now you can die cut your stenciled designs. Okay, we have three new embossing folder designs. This first one is called Crystal Distortion. And look at the texture. It's geometric. It's mesmerizing. And then next we have Triangle Burst. I die cut this one out of Doll Pink to show you. I mean, it's just, she's a showstopper. I'll tell you that. And then lastly, we have the Circle Rings. Now this one is very, very detailed. I don't know if you can see the repeating circle rings pattern in this. These are great for adding phenomenal texture to your backgrounds. Okay, moving on to the stencils. First up, we have layered bats, and these look like they're sized for a slimline card, but you certainly can use them on a standard size. You could use these stencil individually, but when you layer them, you get kind of a spooky, eerie layered bats background, perfect for Halloween. Next, we have the leaves wreath. Again, another layering stencil. So you've got the blooms and the leaves, and you've got the branches. And when you layer them together, you can get a really fun wreath design for the fall. Next, we have the printmaking houses stencil set. This is one of those where you get the inner and the outer. So I took all the inner parts out to show you get like the basic house shape, and then all those smaller ones which could be used for windows. You could create your own type of printmaking style house. Next we have Waves of Change stencil, and this one's really intricate. I love the wavy design. You might want to use some of that pixie spray to hold that down. And then we have the layering raindrops. So you could use these, of course, individually, but when you layer them, you get this kind of a bokeh raindrop design. You see how when you layer them like that, but you could also use them individually. Next up is the Stepped Back Blocks stencil set. There's four stencils in this set, and as always, you can use each one of these stencils individual. You can layer two at a time, three at a time, or all four together. The possibilities are really endless, creating this gorgeous kind of stepped back blocks design. It's like geometric and layered. It's really stunning. And then to pair with all those coffee projects, we have the coffee drinks. And this is just like the background cling, only it's a stencil. So you can ink blend your coffee themed background. Okay, lastly, we have the mini slimline masks. We've had these for the A2 and the A4. Now we have the mini slimline. And you get three different sizes of the rectangle to create borders on your slimline, and you get the inner and the outer. So maybe you want to ink blend just the outer part of your panel. You can do that too. And you can also layer these to create a really unique design. Okay, moving right along to some Kathy Zilski products for Stemptember. This first one is called Love That Student, and it's got coordinating dies to go with it. It's just so cute to create encouraging cards for your favorite student. There's also a die that pairs perfectly with it called A+. And I die cut this one to show you that big A+ with a backer shadow. You use those two together to create really cute school-themed student projects. Okay, this one's called Ornamental Christmas. Again, it does have the coordinating dies to go with it, and it pairs great with the ornamental cling. So these kind of coordinate together for some really unique Christmas themed projects. And then we have for Thanksgiving, we have the Chunky Thankful word die, and I die cut this one to show you out of two different shades of green. I love that chunky font. And then we have the Clean Line Extra Large stamp set. There are coordinating dies to go with this. I didn't have them, but there are some to go with it. I love the clean lines of these classic all-purpose sentiments. And then for Halloween, we have the Creepy Crawlers Background Cling from Kathy Zilski. It's clean, it's modern, it's Halloween spiders coming down the spider web for Halloween. Some more exciting new products for Stamptember are some hot foil plates. This first one is called Love, and it is just like there's a Love word die and a Love stamp set in this same font by Christina Werner, and I foiled this one to show you how it looks in gold. It's absolutely stunning. Next, we have the Joyful Christmas Hot Plate. I die cut this one in gold onto green. And I mean, talk about a classy Christmas sentiment. There's nothing classier than gold foil. You know what I mean? Okay, here's one, a slimline. It's called Falling Leaves. Of course, you don't have to make it slimline. You could trim it down for a standard size card. But gorgeous falling leaves design in gold or any shade of foil that you have. Here is the, what's it called? Mini Slimline Falling Dots. And that could be cute for like snow or confetti. And then lastly, we have the Slimline Congratulations. I did this one in gold onto some pink cardstock, and it's size for a slimline. There are 6 new sentiment strips designs in the Stamptember release. You get the black on white and the white on black. This first one's called Reverse All the Thanks. You get 4 sheets in each pack. My favorite is the white on black, but if you like the black on white, you know you can also foil these. This one's called All the Thanks. Again, 4 sheets of sentiment strips. And then we have the Merry Christmas ones. This is the Reverse Merriest Christmas. And oh gosh, these would be gorgeous foiled in red foil. And then you have the Merriest Christmas. I can't tell you how often I use these sentiment strips. Probably one of my most used products by Simon's the Stamp. Now we have the Reverse Spooky Salutations. And then we have the black on white, which is just the Spooky Salutations. Again, you get 4 sheets in each pack and they can be foiled. Next up, we have a new set of Susie's Doodles watercolor cards. This set is called Welcome Autumn, and these are pre-printed on watercolor cardstock. So you can color them with a variety of mediums, watercolor, Zig Clean Color markers, watercolor pencils, Copics, crayons, you name it. Kids love them. They make a great gift set too. And now for the extras. You're gonna love the extras. First up is the Craft Glue Stick made for Simon's the Stamp. It's got the cute Simon's the Stamp packaging, and it's just a glue stick, another option for adhesive. And then you have this adorable enamel pin. It says, I heart Simon's the Stamp. So cute. And you can add that to your enamel pin collection. There are 2 different sizes of red line tape for Simon's the Stamp. One is a 1/4 inch wide and one is a little thinner. It's an 1/8 inch wide. And these are super duper sticky, permanent adhesive. Next up is a pack of A2 holographic rainbow sheets. You get 6 sheets in each pack and they are rainbow holographic cardstock. Drop dead gorgeous. There are also 2 new sequin mixes in this release. This first one is called Party Time, and it's mainly a pink sequin with some rainbow and iridescent in there. Oh man, love that one. And then we have Coral Cabana, and it's got coral and teal and aqua, a little iridescent yellow. And there's also a pack of clear acetate sheets. Full size, 8.5 by 11. You get 5 sheets in a pack. They're heat resistant, great for shaker cards. I believe you can emboss on them. Okay, moving on to the blender brushes, which I'm sure that you've seen by now. You might already have some, but they're also part of the Stamptember release. They have some great features. One is they come with caps. So if you don't have storage solution, you throw them in a drawer. They're not going to contaminate one another. Or you need to throw them in a bag if you're traveling. Great to have a cap. They've got color-coded handles. And the cute little Simon's the Stamp paw logo on the back. And then there's a large set and there's a small set. You can also buy them individually. I have found that these little small ones are so great when you have little parts that you need to stencil a little area. Very handy dandy. I love the cap feature because especially for my minis, I throw those in my drawer and I know they're not going to get dirty and contaminate one another. So again, You can buy these in sets, whether you want to buy the large set or the small set. You can also buy them individually. Okay, moving on to one of the most exciting things of Stamptember is the new sets of Simon's Stamp Positively Saturated ink pads, and these come in trios. You can also buy them individually, but there are 5 different trios right now. There's more to come, but we have a pink trio, an orange, a yellow, a green, and kind of a bluey aqua. And each one has a light, medium, and dark tone, and they're absolutely delicious. Like I said, there's 5 different trios. I swatched them out to show you. I made a little swatch chart here so you can see the light, medium, and dark tone. And I just got to tell you, I got to show you the ink. It's a different formula than the other Simon's Stamp ink. It's a cushier. They blend like butter. And when I stamped them for my chart, I only stamped them one time. One stamp for this stamp chart. And did you notice they're pre-labeled on the edges? They're labeled for you. Delicious color. Blend like butter. And the colors, the trios are just, I mean, forget about it. Very exciting. And that is everything from the Stamptember 2021 release. Thank you for hanging in there. Before we go, I just wanted to share a couple of projects that I've created using some of these Stamptember goodies. This first card features the neighborhood house dies, and I use one of the sentiment label dies. And this one features the paper layering circles along with another sentiment label die. Make sure and check out the Simon's Stamp blog for more information and inspiration. Thank you so much for joining me. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you next time.